Hi guys, my name is Mary. I'm going to be doing the second half of January reading for you all. January 16th through the 31st reading for Pisces. Happy New Year, you guys. Hope everybody has a great year. 2020, unbelievable, right? Kind of crazy already. This is for your sun, moon, and rising signs. It's not going to resonate with everyone. If it doesn't resonate, you might want to try your other signs. I've already meditated on the cards, you all. And we're going to be trying the new deck of tarot cards today. Hope you guys like them. Be patient with me because I gotta try to figure them out as I look at them. For some reason, the pages and the knights look a lot alike. All right, you all, let's see what we've got. Seven of Swords. The Fool card, the Hermit, the Moon, Eight of Cups, and the Ace of Cups. Hope you guys can see those. The World card, the Four of Cups, and the Seven of Wands. Third chakra, Archangel Shamuel, and fourth chakra, Archangel Raphael. Angels. Don't stop. Perfect timing. Give me just a minute, okay? All right, you all. There's something that has been or that will be getting under your skin a little bit. Now, it's going to be a little bit different for everybody, so I can't specifically, but let's say it's somebody at your job, at your work, a coworker, a friend of yours, a family member, a child, a parent. It can go in a lot of different directions. But there's something or a situation, it doesn't necessarily have to be the person, but there's a situation where you guys are saying, you know what, I've had enough of this. Now, I believe with this walking away and with this sneakiness up here, that that's who we're talking about. I believe that there's someone in your life that has been a little bit sneaky, deceiving, dishonest, something about them that you just had rather not be around anymore. So sometimes hold on just a second. Sometimes for some of you all, let's put it that way, this has been going on for a minute or two or weeks or months, maybe years. And you finally come to the point to where you're like, that's enough. I ain't putting up with that no more. So that's kind of why I feel like it could be a coworker, but it could also be a family member or a friend of yours. And you guys are kind of tense about it, kind of a little bit stressed out about it, or you have been stressed out about it. You've tried to figure out what you should do. You could possibly be wanting to meditate, pray, be by yourself. Everybody leave me alone. Let me lock myself in my bedroom or in my house. And I just want to be able to figure out what I should do next. And when you do that, you start gaining personal, hold on, not personal, spiritual guidance, spiritual understanding, belief, knowledge. And when that happens, you guys go, you know what? I'm going to do this with my life. I'm going to change it this way. I'm going to take this bad situation, and it might not be a totally bad situation, you know, it's a part of life, it's life experiences. But I'm going to take this situation and make it positive for myself. Some of you guys, small handful, this could be a child, an adult child, or a teenager. And you guys have probably been helping, advising, giving money to, giving a home to, giving your vehicle, helping with bills. And then all of a sudden you're like, you know what, wait a minute. I can't do this anymore. Because there's going to be some kind of deceit and you're going to find out about it. But there is good news with this. Because when you quit doing that particular thing or helping that particular person, or when you get out of that situation, you're going to feel like a ton of bricks have been lifted off your shoulders. You're going to feel like a new person again. You're going to feel like yourself. You're going to feel alive. You're going to feel emotionally happy and satisfied. And you're just going to feel good again. Sometimes you got to have, for some of you, tough love. Sometimes you have to make a choice or decision that you don't really want to make, and you've been thinking about it for quite some time, but you're just going to have to do it. Because I have this world card here too, you all. And when I get the world card, I feel like that part of your life is coming to an end, so a new cycle begins, a new beginning begins for a lot of you all. A new way of thinking, a new way of living, a new job possibly, a new home maybe. So when this situation happens, I think it's been happening for most of you guys for a minute, for a while. And you're just finally getting to where you're like, okay, I gotta put my foot down. I can't do this anymore. But this is going to open up a whole world. I shouldn't say world, it makes it sound so dramatic. A whole new way of thinking, a whole new way of living, and a whole new life for a lot of you. Even if it's something minor. It's just a whole new way of taking charge, standing up, doing something you want to do, instead of maybe throwing money at something that like an adult child, for instance, that doesn't appreciate it or that doesn't help themselves. And there's something about this that you're like, okay, that's enough. That's enough. You're going to figure out that some things are not always as they seem or as they appear to be, especially if it's this person or this situation. So in the past, you may have thought, oh, they need my help. I got to do this. I got to do that. And then now you're going to realize, no, they don't. They need to help themselves. But in the meantime, you have two angels by your side. And you know, they say, if you want help from your angels, you need to ask. So remember that. You have free will. And unless you ask, they can't do a whole lot to help you, but they're right there by your side. They're wanting to help you. The third chakra archangel, Shamuel, is emotions, enthusiasm. Fourth chakra is love and compassion and accepting yourself. Receiving love from other people. Realizing that no matter what, you're making the right choice. Because these two cards make me feel like that you're just defending yourself and your life. Your respect. Your job, your work. You as a person. Your intuition's going to be stronger. You guys already know what I'm talking about. I think it's already started, to be quite honest. Your instincts, your intuition, your gut feelings, your inner guidance. The little voice in your head. Don't do that, do this. So it says that this is the perfect timing and don't stop. Give me just a minute, okay? I'm gonna rearrange. I don't know, which one do you want to... It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, these two. They're both exactly, in my mind, they're both good. Let me make sure those are straight. I hope you can see them, you all. For some reason, there's someone in your life or a situation in your life to where you've been trying to help. Maybe it's just advice. For some people, it's you're giving money or you're giving help in one way or another, giving them a place to stay, possibly. Some of you guys, maybe it's just advice. And sometimes, once you help and help and help and help and help, it's finally like, okay, you guys, I can't help anymore. For some reason, you're going to find something out, whether it be deceitful or dishonesty or... some kind of something not so good. And it's gonna like bum you out for a little bit. And you're gonna be like, you know what? What am I supposed to do with that? And why am I getting picked on? These are part of life experiences. This is you guys defending yourself from this person or this situation that you're about to walk away from. Because you've seen it in a different light. You saw them needing your help, and now all of a sudden it's going to be like a split second you're going to realize that's not the case. They weren't totally honest with me. You're going to walk away from that situation. You're going to pray and meditate. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just suggesting you might want to pray and meditate. And when you do that, and when you open up your spiritual inner guidance, you're going to feel stronger. You're going to feel more alive. You're going to feel like you're doing the right thing for yourself. And you are, because this is a new cycle. This is the World card saying that that cycle's a completion. This is a new cycle and a new year, and it's a new you. You're ready to take this new journey. You're ready to do something for yourself for a change, instead of looking out for everyone else or that one person or that one situation. And you're going to be happy as you can be when it's all said and done. You have angels looking out for you. If you need their help, you need their strength, you need their guidance, ask. You also, it also says don't stop in perfect timing. So I think that for some of you guys, you've been wanting to do this for a very long time, and you've just kind of been putting it off, or thinking that they needed you more than they deceived you somehow, some way. And because of that, just like that, you find out the truth, or you see the truth, or something happens, and the next thing you know, you're like, okay, I love you, but I gotta walk away from this situation. So that's how I'm feeling about it. And it is perfect timing. Perfect timing, you all. Perfect timing for you, perfect timing for that person, perfect timing for the ending of that situation. So a new world, a new cycle, a new chapter, a new way of living comes in for you guys. A new way of thinking. And it might be something extremely small. It's not going to be something humongous for everybody, but it might be something that is going to make you be happy again, be emotionally free, emotionally fulfilled, emotionally satisfied again. Love, new beginnings. Maybe even a new person coming into your life. Maybe an old person getting back together with. But I just have a good feeling that you guys, after this is all said and done, you're going to be extremely happy and satisfied, and you're going to love the way you handled it, because you guys have this loving heart, and you don't want to ever say no to anyone or say that you can't help anyone. So that's why it's been going on for such a long time. But sometimes, let's say it's just advice, and you've been giving advice and trying to help someone, and the next thing you know, they never get out of that situation, or they keep digging themselves in a deeper hole kind of thing. And you're like, come on, I've been trying to help you over the last month, 6 months, a year, 5 years, whatever it is. And you know that there's no way that you can help them. You realize it. And in return, when you walk away from it, you're going to be tickled for yourself. It's going to be a big relief. It really is. So I know you guys don't like to do it, but it's going to be a blessing in disguise. So just realize that, okay? All right, Pisces. This is your second half of January reading, January 16th through the 31st reading for Pisces. I hope you guys have enjoyed this today. Don't panic over this. This is something that needs to be done. And I think once it's all said and done, you're going to feel such a relief. It's unbelievable. All right, you all, Happy New Year, and I will see you guys soon. Take care. Bye.